Hello friends, welcome to Wall Street Mojo's Investment Banking Tutorial. Today's topic is one variable data table, and we will see why it is important from the point of view of calculating sensitivity analysis in Excel. Sensitivity analysis is a very important concept, and we frequently use that in various valuation models, including the dividend discount model. The formula here in front of us is known as the Gordon growth formula. This is nothing but a dividend discount model where we calculate the valuation of the stock using constant growth. So the formula here looks like a bit complex, but it's very, very simple. Value of the stock is nothing but D0 into 1 plus G divided by KE minus G. D0 is the value of the dividend which is received this year. G is the constant growth rate in the dividend. D1 is the value of the dividend to be received next year, and KE is the discount rate. So D1 is nothing but the dividend which is received this year multiplied by 1 plus growth rate in the dividend. So if you are worried about the mechanics of this formula, you can go ahead and look at our tutorial on dividend discount model in detail. But the context of the discussion now is about one variable data tables. So many a times what happens is when we calculate valuations, we would like to change the discount rate or maybe the growth rate and see what's the effect on the valuation of the stock. So in that context, we'll take this basic example where we have this constant growth model, price of the stock we need to find out. We have been provided with the current year dividend, and we are also given the expected growth rate. That's the growth rate G, that's 4%, and the expected return on the cost of equity, that's 10%. So I'll do that right away in an Excel. So we have been provided with this basic example where the current year dividend is $3, expected growth rate is 4%, and the expected return is 10%. Now let's find the value of the stock on the basis of Gordon growth formula. So the Gordon growth formula essentially said that this is a value of the stock is the dividend in the current year multiplied by 1 plus growth rate divided by the cost of equity or the expected return minus the growth rate. All right. So this comes out to be 52.0. So this is the fair value of the stock, which represents the current year dividend, and there's a dividend growth of 4% each year, right? So let's move forward. So what are we trying to achieve when we talk about one variable data table? So let's create some scenario. What if the expected returns change from, let's say, 10% to 12%, 12% to 14%, or maybe otherwise? So how will the value of the stock shift when the expected returns change? So that's where one variable data table can be extremely useful. So let's say the expected return is 6% or 7%, or we can probably create one whole table of this and see what are the corresponding changes in terms of valuation. So as we can see here, there's one variable that changes. The variable that is changing here is this expected return. Okay, now when this variable is changing, there are two ways to find out the expected output or the value of the stock here. The first one is the donkey work. Obviously, the donkey work is something which we don't want to do, but for argument's sake, I'll just show what it means. So here it means that we rewrite the whole formula again and again like this. 1 plus growth rate divided by the expected return minus the growth rate. All right. So we get the answer as 156. But what about the value when the expected return changes to 7%? We have to rewrite the formula again. So this means rewriting the formula by only changing one variable. This is from 6%, it now becomes 7%, and the value changes. So we can do that again and again, again and again. And I don't want you to actually do this. Instead, I would like you to do a smart work that's called as the usage of something called data tables to perform sensitivity analysis. So here the basic approach is, and here this is very important, please listen carefully. The first step is when you write this variable in this standard format, okay, above that please link your initial set of variable. What's your initial set of variable? You said that there's at 10%, what is your expected output? The value of the stock is 52. So think of this as inputs, which you have to give to the table, the data table, okay? At 10%, the value of the stock is 52. Please don't write it manually, always link it. These are the inputs, all right? Now, choose these from top to bottom with these as vacant as of now. Go to data, go to what if analysis, go to data tables. All right. Now, there are two inputs which are required. Now, since this is a one variable data table, you are expected to write only one input. Now, this is a column input because as you can see, it's in a single column. So, the column input is what? The expected returns. These returns which are changing is the column input. Now, this original input was written here, right? So that's where you need to link it from. Okay, so once you do that and you press OK, you'll find that all the answers which were desired are already there. So if you see inside these, it gives us table bracket. This is row and this is column. All right. So what this data table does is it goes and sees your initial inputs and the expected output. It traces the expected output to the original formula and recalculates and does it the same way for the other set of input variables. So that's how this one variable data table actually works. You can also do the same for the other set of variables. So say for example here, there was this variable called expected return that changed right here. You can also make the growth rate change and see what's the expected output. So let's try this growth rate. And as you now may remember that we need to provide the input here. The input is now 4%, all right? And what's the output? The output is $52, all right? So this is the input, this is the output. This is the way you know you need to create the data table. Now let's change this growth rates. 5%, 6%, 7%, 8%, all right? Now let's assume that this is the table that we have and we want to see the results on these growth rates. Okay, so first thing again, you need to choose the whole table. All right, go to data, go to what if analysis, go to data tables. So is this a row input or a column input? As discussed, this is the column input because it's in a single column H. All right, so go there. Your original input variable sits here. So that's where you need to connect it from and then press OK. So you'll be blessed with the final answers and it will help you with a lot of time-saving activities.